Hello, and welcome to our training today. Excited to be with you and to share with you some great things today about email marketing. First, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Bruce Ekman, and I'm the founder of EasyNet Tools Incorporated, and I will be your presenter today. Over the years, we've worked with literally thousands of businesses and help them build websites and help them to be successful. And so we've learned a lot from those customers. We've learned things to do and things not to do. Some of the things we learned are from hard knocks. And so the objective of these seminars is to share with you the things that we've learned over the years from these thousands of customers to help you be successful without having to suffer the hard knocks part. So That's our objective with this. Today's training is titled Email Marketing Basics. And I think that this is a really important training session because email marketing should be really central to your whole internet marketing machine. Email marketing is what you want to really focus everything to. And so today we're going to share with you some of the basic elements of successful email marketing and hopefully can help you to be more successful in your online business. Today we're going to cover several things. The first thing we're going to talk about is what email marketing is and why it's important to your business. Then we'll talk a little bit about spam. That's a big issue when it comes to email marketing. And then we're going to cover three keys to having a successful email marketing. So that's what we'll cover in today's webinar. Okay, so first let's talk about just what is email marketing. And really I think there's a lot of misconceptions out there about email marketing and as far as what it really is. When you get email in your email box that was not solicited and you didn't ask for it, that is not email marketing. That is spam. And what we're going to talk about today is, in a lot of cases, the difference between spam and email marketing. This is a definition of email marketing. And what we like to do, there are two kinds of marketing practices out there, whether it be SEO, whether it be email marketing, whatever. There's what's called white hat and black hat. Black hat's the bad guys. That's the guys that are doing the spam. And we don't like those kind of tactics. White hat is where we like to be. And so we want to teach you the right things to do with email marketing so you can do it and be a white hat kind of a person and not the black hat. The real difference between black hat and white hat email marketing is what's called opt-in or opting in. That means that you've given the customer, or they've actually given you their permission to send them an email. And what you want to be, you would want to be beyond that. Not only do you want their permission, you want them to really be looking for it, waiting for it, excited to get it. So we'll talk a little bit about some ways that you can do that. So here's a definition of opt-in email advertising. Opt-in email advertising or permission marketing is a method of advertising via email whereby the recipient of the advertisement has consented to receive it. This method is one of several developed by marketers to eliminate the disadvantages of email marketing. Okay, so spam is bad, opt-in marketing is good. And we like to even go beyond just permission. We want people to be excited, waiting for it. They like your email, and so that's where you need to be, and that's what we're going to talk about doing today. Okay, permission marketing follows a strategy. And it's sort of a funnel, but there's a gentleman out there called Seth Godin, and he wrote a book called Permission Marketing. It's has some great concepts. In this book, he talks about there being two kinds of advertising or marketing out there. There's what's called interruption marketing, and interruption marketing is when, you know, you're watching your favorite TV show, and it gets right to the most exciting part, and all of a sudden, bam, a commercial for something stupid that you really didn't even want in the first place. That's interruption marketing. You're being interrupted with some kind of advertisement. It's in your face. You really don't want it. And you know, over the years, we have built up, our minds are automatically trained. We have this, we go into skip mode, okay, when you see those commercials come up. So commercials are becoming less and less effective. And for that reason, they're actually becoming more and more expensive, which makes interruption marketing not a good place to be, okay? So with email marketing, you want to work more off of the permission marketing and not be interruption marketing. You want to get people's permission to send it to them. And sometimes you may need to do a little interruption marketing to get permission, but you want to get over to the permission side as quick as you can. And with this strategy, what you want to do is you want to take strangers, people who don't know who you are, and you want to turn them into friends, people that are interested in you, that like you, and that look for your emails or your advertising, your marketing materials, whatever it is you're sending there, you want them to be friends. Then you want to take those friends and you want to turn them into customers, people that buy from you. And then once they're buying from you, you want them to buy from you again and again. So you want them to repeat their purchases. And not only do you want to make them repeat customers, you want to make them raving fans. And a raving fan is somebody that's just excited to do business with you. They're going to tell other people about you. They're going to be out there promoting your business for you. And the internet can be a very effective way to do that. Okay. So this is the steps that we go through with permission-based marketing. Now, with the interruption marketing, they want to cut straight to making somebody your customer. You're trying to sell them something in their face, get them to buy right now, and you're skipping the friends step. And so I think it's really important in this day and age to really understand this philosophy. What we want to do is we want to work with people. We're not going to get customers right away. We want to work with them. We want to move them along slowly until they're our friends, and then they will turn into our customers. And society's changing. Marketing is changing. Advertising is changing. And so we as business owners need to follow the trends. Permission marketing is becoming more and more a practice out there of businesses. And the in-your-face marketing is just becoming less and less effective. So this is a great concept for you to use and for you to understand. Okay, email marketing done correctly in the White Hat method is reported to be the second most effective online marketing tactic. Okay, number two, search engine marketing is the first to get traffic and to get those people to your website. Or to your page to get them to sign up to whatever email marketing you have going on. But it is reported as the number two marketing method out there on the internet. So this is really, really important. And I think a lot of website owners do not take advantage of this powerful, powerful marketing method. Okay? I want to make sure absolutely in your mind, you're going to see as we go through this training today, I'm really going to push some certain points very, very hard. And one of the points that I want to make, and I really want to make it strong to you, is email marketing is not spam. That is not email marketing. That is spam, and we do not want to do that. That is bad, and it can cause bad things for your business as well. So don't spam. And we'll talk about the difference between email marketing and spam. Okay, one of the things that you want to do with email marketing, and really not only your email marketing, with all of your marketing, I think marketing is like fishing. You know, if you go out there and you tie a fork or something, you know, on the end of your line, you're probably not going to catch a fish. Maybe if it's shiny, that'll be interesting to them. But, you know, if you tie a rock on there or something, you're not going to do as well as if you put something on your hook that the fish is interested in, okay? So in any kind of marketing practices, and especially in email marketing, put yourself in the eyes of the fish. What is it do your customers want? What do they need? What will they look forward to, okay? So you need to decide who your fish are, who's your target market, and then put yourself in their shoes and look through their eyes and try to figure out what they want, what they like, what's going to be good for them. And that's what you want to do with your email marketing. This is so incredibly important. There are so many people out there that send out emails and they don't look at it through the eyes of the fish. And I'm amazed at the piles and piles of email that I get, and even email that I've given permission to somebody to send to me, and it's obvious that they have not put themselves in my shoes and looked through my eyes to try to see what I want. Give your target market what they want. Give them what they need, and you will be successful with your email marketing. This is so incredibly important. It's not what you want, it's what your customers want that's going to make you successful and your willingness to give it to them.